might know Windows Neptune if you have wandered around Windows for a while. We're gonna take a look at what changes within Windows XP's prequel, the one and only available Windows Neptune build for now, build 5111. The setup starts with the Windows 2000 setup changed to Neptune setup. Subtle changes. Apart from the jumbled EULA, the text mode setup doesn't bring any changes. But what's changing is the upcoming graphical setup. The boot screen is now displaying Neptune rather than Windows 2000. The graphical setup uses Windows Neptune logo as well as the progress bar, which is absent in Windows 2000. The remaining setup remains as is without major changes. While the setup is setuping, I'll tell you the basic story of how Windows Neptune exists, or did exist. Basically, Neptune is a project that is supposed to be for the next consumer version of Windows after Windows 98. The project is built upon the Windows NT code base, specifically forking from Windows 2000 release Canada 2. Windows Odyssey is supposed to be the counterpart of Neptune, the next business version of Windows after Windows 2000. Neptune would supposed to be succeeded by Windows Triton. After delays, Neptune project is cancelled in favor of Millennium, later called Windows Me, and the development team for Windows Odyssey would later be merged with Neptune development team to create Windows Whistler, later known as Windows XP. Contrary to the kids' belief, specifically you Windows never released kid, no builds of Windows Odyssey and Triton ever released, and only one build of Neptune available to the public, which we are currently installing. Now, when we enter the desktop for the first time, Windows will ask you to enter a username. This is crucial because this will be your username when you enter Windows Neptune. And just like that, the OS restarts and we're gonna see the desktop properly. Rebooting the OS for one last time, the desktop shows that this looks just like your typical Windows 2000 desktop. But oh boy, there will be some awesome and cool additions later on. Let's start off with the watermark at the bottom right corner of the screen that says Windows Neptune and the build number. And just to make sure that this is actually Windows Neptune build 5111, this is the WinVir, and this is the system properties. Opening the Windows Explorer, the graphic behind My Computer is a different variant than what we have in Windows 2000 and Windows Me. And when we open the WinNT folder, the gear background at the bottom right corner of the screen is a little bit different than in Windows 2000. Does this graphic originate from Windows 2000 release Canada 2 or Neptune original? Well, tell us in a comment down below. A small thing I just bothered to look at is, well, no 3D pinball. I don't know why. It's available in Windows 2000 and Windows Me, but not in Windows Neptune. Neptune is supposed to be the consumer-oriented version of Windows. Well, sorry, I overreacted for that. Next, my picture slideshow, which isn't available in the original Windows 2000, but it is available in Windows Me. This feature was originally ported from Windows Me build 2394. The screensaver is taking images from my pictures folder and displaying them as a slideshow in a screensaver. I would try it with images from Windows Vista by, of course, copying it to the virtual machine. And it works! Internet Explorer in this build is technically a fusion between 5.0 from the original codebase and a pre-release version of 5.5. This is proven to be a fact by checking out the About dialog, which displays version 5.5 in the banner, even though the version listed in it is version 5.0. And now, let's slowly unveil the real new changes in this build of Neptune, one by one. Starting with the help and support. This looks like just a normal help and support for Windows 2000, right? Well, technically, yeah, you're not wrong. But there is an alternate version of help and support that we've already seen for ages in this video, sitting with us all along. Take a look at the desktop. Check out the file bug report shortcut. Double-clicking it will display a new version of help and support, in this case, to report bug to the Neptune beta team. This works just like a bug report you would expect, such as contact info, issue info, and system info. What is interesting is when we go to the home section of the program. This is taken, or can be said as ported from Windows ME, likely from build 2429. Checking out some links within the application, such as getting started, that shows literally nothing, using system restore that throws an error, empty tools and tutorials, blank topics, assisted support, and report a millennium bug which directs you to the same file bug report that we've already seen before. Notice that the millennium name is actually a codename for Windows ME, if you don't know already. All these imperfections are to be expected because it is a beta build, duh. Using the run dialog, we can execute keyring, yes, keyring, which is sort of a credential manager application in which you can store, delete, and manage credentials. When creating a new key, the dialog explicitly says that this is an internal Microsoft tool. Yeah, very internal indeed. Next, control panel. At the first glance, there are nothing wrong with the control panel. It just feels like with these applets. But draw your attention to the Windows Identities applet. Yes, this applet replaces the user account applet, meaning that you cannot run netplwiz in here, normally. Aside from that, opening the applet will greet you with a completely different interface from the rest of the OS. This applet declares itself as an HTML app. Judging by the layout, the applet feels like the current Windows XP user account applet, but it looks even closer to the Windows Vista's user account applet. I don't know why I threw that theory myself, but hey, that's just a theory, a Windows theory. You can change the profile picture, change the name, and change the account type. The account type in this build are very different from what we have in Windows XP. This build introduces 4 types of account. You got the administrator and the guest, which I doubt any of you even remotely uses nowadays. But you see that? Adult and child account? This is supposed to be for a parental control feature, correct me if I'm wrong. To be fair, the adult and child user account can be just simplified with just admin and standard account like what we have in Windows XP. We can also create an account here, no surprise. Next, this build has fast boot support, but it only supports FAT formatted installation for performing better startup time. And even better when you click that subscribe button, because this script is 4 pages long and almost 2000 words. Okay, this one is one of the well-known features of beta builds of Windows XP. The comments feature, which acts as a feedback for any program. But as far as I have experienced, only dialogues and select application that has this feature. Clicking it will display submit a comment dialog that contains simple feedback poll about the regarding feature. But with the dictionary I want to pull out, you can submit a comment about submit a comment. Oh, very meta indeed. Alright, by logging off from the current account, a new login screen is shown for selecting user account with a fresh look. You can press the power button. Not just yet! Ah! Spoiler! If you just click the button, it will hibernate the computer. But by holding the control key while clicking, will actually shut down the computer. And holding the shift key will restart the computer. Oh yeah, the computer name is displayed at the bottom right of the screen. Entering the desktop, you can activate the famous feature from Windows Neptune by copying ac-core.dll from i386 folder on the installation CD to system32 and running regsvr32ac-core.dll on the run dialog and going to the web tab in display properties and adding a file within Windows NT, activity, start, and start page named start.htm, and then click apply. There we go, Windows Neptune's Activity Center. Well, it was taken from its main beta. In the Activity Center, you can run recent programs, which you can't do it easily in here. Go into your files and folders, which you can't do easily in here. Open an email with Outlook Express, the internet with Internet Explorer of course, document with WordPad, music which doesn't exist, photos which doesn't exist, games which doesn't exist too, and help and support for of course help and support. You can customize the look of the feature by modifying starting place, recent programs, my files and folders, and one other theme for the feature. This feature alone has already gone through efforts to reconstruct its functions. The most notable one is by Ken Oath, a former member of Beta Archive, but it doesn't really come into fruition, as Ken leaves the forum before Ken finishes the reconstruction, so no luck. The next feature, OneTouch, is apparently a program for an automatic unattended upgrade running from a network share. Auto Update, which is a service to facilitate software updates through Windows Update. This feature is backported from Windows ME in a non-functional state. An under-the-hood change within this build is the introduction of Prefetch, which improves app startup by caching required dependencies. You can toggle the feature on or off via registry editor in this path using this dword value. This next feature is quite neat and way beyond its time, at least for Windows users. Meet multi-desk with appropriate splash screen. This program allows you to have multiple virtual desktop. Amazing! Adding a new desktop, which I can't right now, but I can after a restart. You can position the bar any way you want. You can add as many desktops as you want. Rename the desktop for multiple purposes, and it crashes when closing a desktop. Oh, jeez. Take that note, Windows 10. This beta build already has multiple desktop feature like this, like 15 years prior. Why would Microsoft not include this in earlier versions such as Windows XP and Windows Vista? Don't ask me. Back to control panel, there's a variant of scanners and cameras applet. And when you run it, well, you can't. The process wouldn't load. This can be solved by copying this text and saving it as reg file and merging it inside the registry editor. And when you open it now, it's just your typical scanners and camera setup. Now, I want to show you several stuff that's quite unique for me. There's an executable named Mars, with that emoticon as an icon, and according to BetaWiki, which you must check it out, this application interprets commands by forwarding user input to marscore.dll that loads an .xml and .htm/hda into a windowed shell application. I interpret this app as kind of a framework, but I don't know the exact visualization that I have for this. Tell us in the comment down below if you know what this actually is, and I really mean it. Next, in the installation disk, there's a system file called srvwiz.dll, which is actually a file for configure your server. This is a leftover from the Windows 2000 server releases. The last one, or at least the last one that I'm showing in here, is self-hosting support, which I can't do it at the moment for myself, but it's supposed to look like this. From the look of Windows Neptune with 5.1.1, we know that there are several visions laid out for the next consumer version of Windows, mainly to ease more people on navigating through the OS by performing daily tasks, especially the Activity Center. But I think this new it actually exists in later version of Windows. That case is just like this beautiful